When I eat it, usually it's kind of the star. You can pickle it, you could eat it raw, you could smoke it, you can really do anything with it.
Hi, my name is Kalani Ortiz. I am a second year fisheries graduate student working under Dr. Rafael Cuevas Uribes, Aquaculture Lab. And my thesis is focusing on the viability and growth of bull kelp here in Humboldt Bay. What your typical bull kelp harvesting day looks like is waking up super early, getting everything prepped on our boat, and going straight to our site. From there, we'll get our crew and lift up the lines and cut each individual up. After we cut each bull kelp, we'll throw it back in a tote, bring it back to our dock, and then bring it in a big fish tote where we'll bring back each individual and process it, weigh it, and measure it, and then distribute it out to our community members along with some of our collaborators. Super grateful for the Food Sovereignty Lab, who is using it for a big project on the Wiyot food distribution and feeding the community, along with working with Sunken Seaweed, who will be using it for their business, and working with different collaborators on expanding the growth of seaweed industry here in Humboldt Bay.
The Food Sovereignty Lab is a program that started as a project in one of the Native American Studies classes in 2019. The Food Sovereignty Lab now helps promote and further food sovereignty for local tribes. When I eat it, usually it's kind of the star. You could pickle it, you could eat it raw, you could smoke it, they can add it to soup, you could dry it, you could put it in a salad with other stuff. It's like salty and it's like an umami flavor, kind of like salty cucumber, crunchy. Really good.
What we did is really try to understand how we can really eat kelp. We cut up an individual, blended it with tomatillos and different types of chiles that are commonly used in a lot of Hispanic or Mexican culture salsas, and pretty much blend that bull kelp in and get this really spicy, yummy salsa that we're all kind of enjoying now.